Wonderful. So in my previous video, I just explained what environment variables are and why they're very useful to hide important information, conceal secret information that shouldn't be public. So let me show you how to define those, for example, in glitch.com. The way that works is that very nicely, Glitch gives us access to a private environment, which is defined here in the .env property. What this means is that this is a place where you can define your own environment variables that are going to be unique just for this service that we are customizing them from. So you can see that it gives us a sort of UI text. We can just look at a text representation of that, if you will, right? Or you can just use the interface, whatever you like better. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to add here a variable, and I'm going to call it the Telegram token, for example. It's typically a convention that that environment variables are defined in all caps, just because they're always the same, they're constant. So that's how they're typically defined. And now the value for that variable is going to be this string that we have here. So this whole thing that we have here. So let me see the plain text representation of that, for example. Yes, so this is working. And then now in my main code, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hide this stuff. I'm going to remove it here from the public code. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to point to where in my system this variable is living. In the case of Glitch, because it is a Node.js-based environment, Node.js gives you access to environment variables by accessing the process object, which is an object that defines properties of the process that is running this server. Then we access the environment property, and then here we can type the name of this custom variable that we have created. In our case, Telegram token. And as we do that, I'm going to save this, which it gets saved automatically. It reloads, et cetera, et cetera. And then it looks like things are working. So let me dock this on the side and let me move my Telegram window here. And then let's try if this works. Let's greet Jose Luis. And then it looks like it's doing the thing. And let's echo whatever. And we get here, I received an echo request. This is great. So now, okay, so this is working. Still the same thing. However, we have improved our code a little bit by concealing private information behind an environment variable. So this is really good practice, especially for sensitive information, passwords, and that kind of stuff. So make sure that you never, never version or you never share code with a hard-coded password or a token inside of it. Okay? Wonderful. I think the next thing we're going to do in this video series is that, well, now we have the test bot. We can talk to it, we can echo, we can greet stuff. But what if we connect this bot to the services that we had before, or the examples that we did before in this playlist, where we had the bouncing ball that was synchronized between users? And perhaps what we can do is we can write something where we say ball, and then we type the coordinates here, 0.75, 0.3, and then we have the ball move around to those coordinates. I think that could be a lot of fun. So shall we try that? Let's try that. Let's move on to the next video.